Hello, welcome to my channel. I'm All Things Wrestling, and today I'm going to be giving my thoughts on TNA Impact Wrestling 25th of May 2017. We kick off the show with Bruce Pritchard walking to the ring, clutching his ribs from what happened last week. I believe he got attacked by EC3 or something. I don't know. I didn't watch the end of the show. With Tyrus in tow, he said that he got some personal protection after what happened with EC3 last week. Oh, I was correct. Violence with Impact Wrestling management is not acceptable. EC3's actions will be dealt with. But for right now, he wants to get to the matter at hand, and that's the Impact World title. Bruce Pritchard introduced Bobby Lashley, says this is about his sheer dominance. Lashley says he doesn't care about a game being played by a bunch of nobodies. He's the franchise player, and he wants to know who he gets to beat up at Slammiversary. Didn't this all get settled weeks ago when Alberto took the UWF global title? Ethan Carter III comes out. Lashley tells him not to do it, but EC3 says that tonight he becomes the number one contender. Goes to Slammiversary and becomes the EC3 time world champion. I like that tagline. Please let him do it. Magnus comes out to the ring and says his credentials speak for themselves. Lashley has never been in the ring with him. He tells EC3 to shut his mouth for a few seconds because he returned to Impact Wrestling to fight a crusade against the terror of Pritchard's regime, the terror that cost him his title and the golden ticket to Slammiversary. Yeah, if that's a golden ticket to Slammiversary, why is all of this shit going on? He'll become the number one contender tonight and go on to face Lashley at Slammiversary. James Storm comes out and says Lashley has a teeny head and a giant body. Then tells everyone to step out of the ring so he can dish a beat down. Proof Spirit of God said there will be a triple threat match tonight, and the winner will face the champion at his anniversary. So nothing to do with Alberto. So what the hell was this whole "this is my golden ticket" crap about then? Bruce sweetens the pot and says he'll even make it a no DQ match. But if anyone touches each other before the match tonight, there won't be a match and they will be suspended indefinitely. And then he dared them to do it. It was funny. It was good. Good, decent opening segment. Then EC3 is backstage, says a triple threat match was named after him. He said he's going to take James Storm out and celebrate with a drink in the form of a bottle he's going to break over his head before he goes to Slammiversary and become the EC3 time world champion. Fairly good promo. Then we go to KM and Kongo Kong versus Braxton Sutter and Malibara Shearer. I'm just going to say Shearer from now on because I'm not repeating that name over and over again. Shearer made a tag allowing Sutter to come in and go after Kong. They brawl to the floor. Ali comes in and brawls with Sienna and Laurel. She takes both of them out with a crossbody. Kongo headbutts Shearer and allows KM to roll him up for the win. Fairly decent match. The fight continues after the match. The men fight to the back while Sienna and Laurel beat Ali up. Rosemary comes out and the mean girl thinks she's going to help him, but she blows Miss straight into Sienna's face and then picks Laurel up and gives her a red wedding. And then Rosemary and Ali having an uncomfortable stare down. That was actually really good. We don't know her agenda, but I'm intrigued. I give you that. This whole situation is enjoyable right now. I like the whole Shearer Sutter pairing. It's all good. And Laurel is mental as well, so everything works out. Then we had the GFW Tag Team Title Tournament semi-finals. Veterans of War versus Mario Bokura and Fola Ba. I don't know. Mayweather flattens Bokura and then when he tags in, and then makes tag to Wilcox, who cleans house on Baraka while Mayweather lays Baha out on the floor. They hit their finisher on Baraka, and then that's all she wrote. That was a decent match. I like the Veterans of War. The other team had hard to pronounce names, so I do not like them. They can piss off, but Veterans of War, Mayweather and Wilcox are very intriguing. I do like it. Then Brutus Magnus is backstage and says anything can happen in this triple threat match, but he's the most cerebral guy in the company. Others will learn the hard way that he'll be world champion again at Slammiversary. That's alright. Then Josh Matthews comes out and he says he and his partner of his choosing will face face JB and Josh Matthews at Slammiversary. He asks Jeremy Borash, piss off, lies. to join him in the ring. Josh says that he has made a lot of mistakes since Money and he's trying to atone for them. He did mention that he's become the vice president of Impact at some point during this whole thing, which was mental. He apologised to Mark today for taking the job, but unblocked Dave Pender and then followed him on Twitter. Apparently, he was like the ring announcer for WCW. And then he wants to apologise to Borash. Josh Matthews comes out and advises Borash as his attorney not to shake his hand. Josh loses it and says he's sick of this because he should be lead announcer instead of these two idiots. Giving these two idiots a rub. He did say, I didn't apologise. It was a good swerve, I give him that. He's going to reveal his partner when he's good and ready. But Joseph says that he won't wait and he can do it right now. Josh calls him a fat, disgusting slob, but a referee comes out and we're ready to get ready for this impromptu match. Abyss went from being a dominant evil person with Rosemary to this crap. I'm letting my protest know. I'm not normally that negative about wrestling, but this is fucking stupid. Joseph Park's character is one of the worst things Impact Wrestling has. Why is it around? It was shit the first time. It's shit this time. Drop the fucking character and let Abyss go back to how he was back in the early 2000s, back 2004, 2005. Just let him do that and it would actually be decent. For God's sake, Impact. Just get some thought into yourself. For fuck's sake. Rant over. Sorry, I hate the character. Josh Matthews vs. Joseph Park. They circle one another and then sirens hit and it's Scott Steiner. Borash heads for the hills. Matthews low blows Parks, allowing Steiner to come in and put the boots to Parks. Put him in the Steiner recliner. Matthews tells the fans it's on because he'll make Josh Matthews and Scott Steiner against these two idiots live on pay-per-view. Guess we'll call this match a no contest. The whole thing was good. I liked it. I can't believe Jeremy Borash picks Joseph Parks as his partner. And then Josh Matthews has Scott fucking Steiner. I did make a point in my live reactions. He's a 54-year-old man. Why would you be that terrified of a man that old? He's way past his prime, I can tell you that now. But what are you going to do? Then we go to a video package of Moose talking about what it means to be the great Impact Grand Champion and how much it sucks to keep getting the title from behind. He sees himself as a top champion in Impact Wrestling and it's his job to defend the title with honour. Then Mackenzie is backstage with Eli Drake and is asked about his disgusting behaviour. Drake says he may not talk and act like they want, but he was backed into a corner and he makes a loud noise when people do that. Moose tried to get in and get at Drake, but security holds him back while Drake says nothing personal. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. He challenged Moose to defend that title next week. Moose says he's got it. Drake jumped Moose and they brawl. Chris Adonis blindsides Moose and they lay him out. Fair enough. I like it. Good thing here. Maybe Eli Drake will hold his title, which I'm very intrigued about. Then we go to the match I was actually looking forward the most to tonight. Davey Richards and Angelina Love versus Eddie and Alicia Edwards. Angelina goes for a Botox injection, but Alicia sidesteps and rolls Angelina up for the win. The match was meh. I wasn't expecting an amazing contest, especially with Eddie being kayfabe injured, so what are you going to do? Eddie hobbles in and hugs his wife, but Davey and Angelina jump them from behind. Davey handcuffs Eddie to the ropes and chokes him until Angelina pulls him off and orders him to get a table. Her husband dutifully follows the order, sets the table up in the ring. Angelina powerbombs Alicia through the table while Eddie screams helplessly on the ropes. Lovely angle. This is one hell of a rivalry. I'm loving this rivalry. Keep it going, please. Then we see Spud in hospital and he says he knows he is supposed to be back in the Impact Zone this week, but the doctors who he trusts very much, a UK doctor, told him he needs one more week. He'll be back and he'll get his revenge. Then we hear a woman yell from off camera and Spud says, "Mom, I'm trying to do an interview. Kayfabe!" It was actually really funny, to be fair. Good thing. And then we go to our main event of the evening. Magnus, Storm, EC3, same ring, same time, no disqualification for your main event. I may have hyped this up more than it was. It was a decent match. Storm drove Magnus with the last call. EC3 shoved Storm out of the ring quickly to cover Magnus. Lovely storytelling that, because there's going to be a proper rivalry between Storm and EC3. They're brewing that really nicely. Magnus is going to get pissed off because of that happening. It's all good. Now, how Alberto Del Rio, Albatron, whatever the fuck his name is, fits into this category, I don't know, because he has his golden ticket. Albatron has a golden ticket. It wasn't mentioned, so how that's going to fit into this whole story of EC3 going to Slammiversary, I do not know. We'll have to wait and see what happens with it. But as always, Impact's been great this week. I do enjoy it. I do hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a like. Please support me on Patreon, link in the description below. Subscribe to see more content, and I'll catch you later.